And now I'm going to invite to the stage your friend and mine, Mohit Sharma.
Thank you, Paul, and I hope everybody's enjoying this session. I think there's a lot to come. The main thing is the doers, the panels. I'm looking forward to that panel session in next after my session. And I think we have consumed a bit of a time during the break. And to make up for the time, I will cut short my presentation. And anything you want, I'm also, everybody knows me, so please feel free to contact me afterwards. And I'll give you the detailed information. But I will just wrap it up faster, my session, because I want the panels to be much more interesting and long. And I'm happy to sacrifice my time for them. About Mindfields, I think everybody knows here, who knows us directly or indirectly. We are a niche firm on automation. We do, I think, I don't want to sell Mindfields here. I want to be just, you know, just let you know how we evolved and what is our vision about our growth. Typically consulting firm, and we were asked to we are the fastest growing company recognized by Deloitte in 2017, and Gartner has also recognized us as one of the niche consulting advisory firm in RPA space. We are the only Austrian owned company other than the big fours. We are not the big four, so among the big fours we are been ranked with them. HFS has just ranked us against Accenture's EYs of the world as second rank for the voice of the customer, and we feel proud of that because I think ultimately everyone wants to work for the customer only, want to meet their KPIs. So we are glad and thankful to my team and our clients for this achievement. So the basic agenda for my session is to brief you on how evolving. How is the clients evolving in the RP journey? How are the tool providers evolving in the RP journey? And how are we evolving in the RP journey? So I will just cover past, present, and future of these three entities in the ecosystem. As we all know, the RP started with routine process. The second will be judgment process, which is the current juncture. And we are seeing a lot of interest from the clients who want to automate the process where you require judgment for loan approvals in the bank, mortgage applications approval in the bank, credit rating company. So how they approve those ratings. So we are doing judgment-based process. Next, going forward, will be analytics-based automation. And we are also looking at automating Hadoop, R, Tableau, using Spark, not only the tools which are in the market like Automation Anywhere, UiPath, Blue Prism, but also looking at the tools like Tableau, Einstein from Salesforce, what features they have got inbuilt, which you can utilize to automate. And going forward, it is AI based. So we are working with some banks on how to automate KYC, AML, using AI features of other tools set in the market, using RPA as a base. We're also doing some work in the OCR, in which it's a pattern-based machine learning and AI-based automation using various tools, and again, making the RPA tool as enabler there. So client journeys, the clients in the team at that time, most of the client thought and believed that automation is a taboo, and they were quite confidential about their journey. They were testing the waters. Now I think the clients are coming up in the open, and it is known, it is the adjective now to when they are saying that we are doing automation in the market. In 2016 they started doing some POCs. Now they are in 2018 they are doing small pilots, which is going live in production, 5 process, 10 process, and going forward they want to scale it up to 50 process, 100 process. I think it will take about 6 to 12 months where the clients start scaling up their operations, and they are learning from their journey in the first phase. So quite briefly, O14 testing the water, O16 starting the POCs, O18 small scale, and 2020 going big. And some clients of ours are already big in terms of 1,000 process in production. I think one of the blue banks here in Australia is doing that. And how are the papers 4 years back with no password controls? Then they got citrus-based applications running on them. Then they got enterprise-level architecture to maintain an architecture, enterprise-wide automation. Then they are using machine learning and AI as add-on as a features in their tools. For example, if you look at IQBot from Automation Anywhere, it is a machine learning and AI-based functionality which they are trying to put an add-on for their enterprise-level RPA tool. You can see UiPath also embedding Abby as part of their next level of features in their tools. I think what we predict is that the tools will evolve fast, more faster. They will get more features more faster, but they will also become quite complementary with other applications in the ecosystem. For example, talking with the cloud, with Azure or with Google Cloud. I haven't seen anybody talking to Alibaba, but I think it will also happen very soon. I think China is the untapped market for automation at this point of time. A lot of our clients, like who have got operations there in China, are trying to explore Alibaba as cloud. How can we store data there? Because they do have some restrictions on Google Cloud. So all these things will evolve. Nothing is going to stop the automation. And we can see the naysayers who were there 3 years ago are also joining the party. Whether it's McKinsey, BCG, Bain, who were naysayers 4 years back, 3 years back, are joining our party now. And I'm very confident that it will grow multifold. How we have grown multifold from 4 people 4 years back to 45 to 65 and to not multiple locations. I think that's the way to grow, and we're just hardly scratching the surface of automation currently. Our journey in 2014, 2016, we grew from 4 to 60 employees, and now we want to, now we want to launch the products, because we believe that the body-based business will become obsolete, and we need to run to catch up that heads up we always have among the other peer level organizations, because the body-based business will become obsolete. What we are trying to do is we are automating our own consulting process to the extent we can. Any repeatable job in a consulting should be automated. And when we do that, the price, the costing of the consulting comes down, which means that the journey for automation or AI for the clients or the other companies who are sitting on the fence will become more cheaper, which means that they can take the journey much, much more faster and much more efficiently. So these tools which we are launching today, COE.exe is already launched. CFO.exe is focusing on the CFOs, and my colleague Sukal will walk you through in detail. MindEasy is automating our own methodology, automating our own consulting process, how we rank the process for automation, how we submit the ideas into the repository, how we rank them. All things has been now automated. How we make a UAT for them, how we deploy them in production, how we monitor them, their analytics, how many times they pass. So it all links or integrate with Blue Prism, Automation Anywhere, and UiPath. So this has been a very big, we are launching it officially today, but we already got 4 clients who have started using it because they don't want to wait till today to get it launched. We have got Mindbots. Mindbots are pre-built bots, because we believe that we have built bots for various clients, and some part of the process is repeatable, like logging into SAP, Salesforce, Oracle apps, or even doing report generation from SAP for reconciliation. Since we have already built those things for other clients, and that is not confidential part of those engagement which we have done with the clients, we can reuse those library at no cost to our other clients. So what we are trying to do is to expedite their journey for RPA and to bring the price down or the cost down for the automation for them. So currently we are the biggest contributor of pre-built bots at the bot store for automation anywhere. Our bots has been the most downloadable bots as per the data shared with us. And I think it shows that the quality of bots we're putting is highly reusable. And we are not charging any money for that. What we want to do is to make it free for people and bring the cost of automation so low that they can start the journey and the business case become more viable for them. Mind support is again, our support for the bots in production, because when the clients build the bots, they want to support now. So they were struggling earlier to have in-house, which were quite expensive for them. So what we are doing is that we are bringing the cost of support so low that it is cheaper than having an in-house person for them. Mind Uni, again, another initiative where we are teaching or we are giving the education on how to build the bots, how to do the consulting at using Mindfields methodology. So we believe that we have an IP, and when we share our IP with our clients, it enhances. We don't believe that by hiding our IP, we'll become rich. I think the more we share, the more we will gain. And we are seeing that the more we have trained our client on the automation journey, the more they are doing, the more they're coming back to us because they want more support. So I think the basic, our principle of giving education free of cost is coming back to us. So I will not take much more of time here, but our clients over last 4 months have, you know, we have won the biggest Japanese company, we have won the biggest water company in WA, largest hospital chains. I think I don't want to, you know, like, I want to be humble here, but so I don't want to boast too much about our credentials here, but I think it's all the hard work of my team and our team and the client's trust in us. Thanks again for your time here. I will not take much of your time. I would like any questions you have, please feel free to contact me. And all these products will be available now in the public domain, and you can get more information about them from us. Thank you very much.